Hi, so here we have a PowerMac 9600. So just to take a quick look at it. So right now it has 200 MHz CPU. So the CPU board is this board right here. And it's running macOS 9. So as you can see, we have 200 MHz PowerPC 604E. And we have only 64 megabytes of RAM. But what we are gonna do right now is try to overclock this PowerPC CPU from 200 to 250 megahertz. So for that, we are gonna remove the CPU board and mess with some resistors on this board. Okay, so before we do that, we are gonna measure the CPU beacon voltage. So I have the multimeter in voltage mode. I'm gonna put one probe on ground, and the other probe, I'm gonna measure the left leg of this voltage regulator over here, and I get 2.75 volts. So right now CPU Vcore is set to 2.75 volts. I'm gonna keep that in mind. So let's turn off the machine. Okay, so it's turned off. I'm gonna unplug the power supply. Make sure to discharge it. Okay. And we are gonna remove the CPU board. Okay. Okay, so we have our CPU board over here. We are gonna open it. So there are 5 screws to remove. And this one over there, and the regulator. We're gonna remove clips. Okay. And put aside the heatsink. So first thing you are gonna notice is that I already replaced some capacitors over there, because I had to recap the whole motherboard because it was unstable, so I also recap some capacitors on the CPU board. For good measure, since we are gonna overclock it, I also added one more on the back over there. It may or may not be needed, but whatever. So here we have got our CPU. If we zoom in a little bit, you can see that this CPU is 604E and 200 MHz rated. So, first thing we are gonna do is take a look at these resistors. So these resistors set the multiplier for the CPU. The base clock of the CPU is over there. It's a 50 MHz one, and it's multiplied by 4. To get the 200 MHz. So right now it's set to this configuration, and this configuration is the by times 4 one. So we're gonna take a look first at this page. So this page is a nice page that shows a lot of methods for overclocking older Macintosh. The one we are interested in is and this section, PCI machines, so we are 9600, but 9500 is similar. The PowerPC 604E, and we want this link right over there. So the website doesn't exist anymore, but if you go on the web.archive.org, you can still find the page. The page looks like this. So this is our CPU board. This is our base clock, which is 50 MHz in our case. And this is the default configuration that we just saw. What we want to do is change this configuration from times 4, which is this configuration we have, to times 5 to get 250 MHz. So what we have to do is swap R13 right there to R9 right there. Okay? So on our board, you have to swap this resistor here to this empty pad there. So let's wait for the soldering iron to heat up. Okay, we're good. Let's add some more solder. Okay. The resistor came off. Now we can put it here. Okay, make sure the pads are soldered nicely. Good. But there is another thing to do. So, just earlier we measured the CPU recall voltage, which was at 2.75 volts. And I already tried to keep this voltage with the 250 MHz clock, and it's not stable. So what we are gonna do is also overvolt the CPU, or rather increase the voltage to its maximum. This CPU is rated for 2.85 volts max, so that's what we are gonna do. And we are gonna take a look at this section over here. So this is our regulator, and we have our voltage divider for the feedback right there. Okay, the feedback section is controlled by a TL431 IC. So I'm gonna look for a datasheet of this IC. So we need a TL431. So we have this package SO8, and in this package you can see that we have a voltage reference over there, and our voltage reference is set to 2.495 volts. So we are gonna measure the existing resistors for this voltage divider so that we know what we have to set them to. So in circuit you are gonna get some red values, so you have to desolder them, or rather just switch them off one pad. So we are gonna switch this one here, this one, this, and now we can measure the resistance. So just as a quick check, I'm gonna okay, so this side is ground, this side is middle point of the voltage divider that goes to the IC over here on this pin, and the other side is the supply voltage. The supply voltage on this board is 12 volts, so I'm gonna measure resistance. This is the bottom resistor, which is 1K, and this is the top resistor, which is 110 ohms. Okay, so on this board, our voltage regulator here, The output is this pin, the input is this pin, and the pin for regulating for the reference is this pin. So this pin goes to the TL431 IC, and the reference pin of the TL431 IC goes to the middle point of the voltage divider. For this voltage divider, the ground is on this side. If we check to ground, we get zero. And the other side, the upper side of the voltage divider, goes to the output. Okay, so if we take a look at a different data sheet that contains some application circuits, so this is the one from Texas Instruments or TL431. We have this example over here to control a voltage regulator. So this is our configuration. The voltage divider is rotor laser, and the voltage on the output follows this formula. So if we compute the voltage on the output using the 2.495 voltage reference typical for this IC and the two resistors of our voltage divider, we get 2.77 volts. So we had around 2.75 volts when we measured it. So this is perfectly normal voltage. So what we want to do is to increase this voltage to 2.85 volts or something like that. So what we have to do is increase this resistance value over there. So for example, if we put a 33 ohms resistor in series with the 110 ohm resistor, we get 2.85 volts. So that's what we are gonna do. Okay, so in this circuit we have to put back the 1 kilo ohm resistor that's right here. This one doesn't change, so we're gonna put it back. But what changes is this one. So we are gonna keep the 110 ohms resistor like this, and we are gonna put another resistor in series. So that's why I shifted one pad, so we have the upper part of the voltage divider that goes into this resistor here, goes out there, will go to our resistor, and then go to the middle point of the voltage divider. So we're gonna solder one pad here, and we're gonna solder the other pad here. Okay, so let me just make those joints look a little bit better. We're gonna need some flux. Okay, should be good. I'm just gonna clean a little bit. And we're gonna secure the resistor with some tape. Make sure not to cover the hole here, which is for the tab for the heatsink. Okay, so we're just gonna put a little bit more thermal paste. I already replaced it recently, so that's why it's still fresh. If you didn't, make sure to replace it. Now we can put back the heatsink. This way, yeah. Before screwing them all the way in, we have to push the tabs. So now we are going to put back the card in the machine. Okay, so we stuck our thermocouple to the CPU heatsink. So the reason for that is because since we overclocked and overvolted the CPU, it's going to heat up more, and in fact it's overheating, so it's gonna crash. So we are just gonna put a thermocouple to see what's going on. And we are gonna insert the CPU card back in. So we are gonna plug back the power cable. Okay. we're going to turn the machine. So it chimes. And we get 2.85 volts, which is what we expected. So if we switch to the temperature reading, I have the thermocouple to the multimeter. We are at 36 degrees. We are booting. And if we go into System Profiler, you will see that our CPU speed is now 250 MHz. So this is just a simple overclock of 50 MHz. Maybe we could push it to 300 MHz by increasing the voltage a little bit over the rating for the CPU and of course adding some cooling. Otherwise you can also replace the crystal by something a little bit more than 50 MHz to increase the base clock, but we are gonna stay at 250 MHz in our case. So right now it's working fine. We are at 40 degrees Celsius on our CPU. Okay, so right now it doesn't want to open Classila anymore. So maybe it's because it's already overheating too much. Yeah, probably the problem. So I'm gonna plug in the fan to cool it down. Okay, so there is a fan. So temperature is dropping to 43 degrees Celsius. We can open Cassia again.